Welcome to a new episode of this series, What If Sherlock Holmes Was a Data Scientist? In this video, we will imagine that Watson harnesses the power of data and machine learning to predict criminals' actions. We dive into a fictional but fascinating scenario and let Sherlock Holmes himself unravel the secrets of confusion matrix visually. Our hypothetical scenario goes as follows.
Sherlock, I've used all the cases we worked on to create a machine learning model that predicts whether a person is a criminal or not.
Then Sherlock replies, how accurate is it?
I think it's accurate enough.
You don't know how to measure its performance, do you?
Listen carefully, Watson. To assess your model accurately, you need to ask four basic questions.
Now, before delving into Sherlock's four questions, let's consider these 100 people as our testing dataset. The evil emoji represents a bad guy akin to real criminal, while the halo emoji symbolizes a good, innocent individual. If Watson's model predicts a person as a criminal, it will be shaded in red. Otherwise, it will be shaded in yellow.
Okay, Sherlock, what is the first question?
How many criminals were correctly predicted by the model?
So how many were predicted as criminals when they are actually criminals? Let me count, that would be 15 people.
Just as a side note, sometimes this is referred to as true positive. True because the prediction aligns with reality, red shade, red emoji, and positive because the prediction affirms that the person is a criminal.
The second question is how many innocents were predicted as criminal by the model? So how many were predicted as criminals when they are actually innocent? Let me count, that would be 10 people.
And this is what known as false positive. False because the prediction doesn't align with reality. Red shade, yellow emoji. And positive because the prediction affirms that the person is criminal.
Two more questions. The third question is, how many innocents were correctly predicted by the model? So how many were predicted as innocents when they are actually innocents? That would be 70 people.
And this is known as true negative. True because the prediction aligns with reality, yellow shade, yellow emoji, and negative because the prediction negates that the person being a criminal.
One question to go. How many criminals were predicted as innocents by the model? So how many were predicted as innocents when they are actually criminals? That would be 5 people.
And this is known as false negative. False because the prediction doesn't align with reality, yellow shade, red emoji, and negative because the prediction negates that the person is a criminal.
Fabulous. In fact, I lied. There are another 4 questions to ask. And here come the fun stuff. You need now to assess the precision of your model. So your model predicted 25 people as criminal, denoted by red shaded squares.
To assess how precise your model is in predicting criminals, you need to ask the following question. Of all these 25 cases, how many were actually criminals?
That would be 15 divided by 10 plus 15 equals 60%.
Oh, that means the next time your model predicts someone as a criminal, there is a 40% chance that it's wrong.
Ouch. The second thing you need to assess is the sensitivity of your model. Your testing dataset has 20 criminals, denoted as the devil emoji.
To assess how sensitive your model is in detecting criminals, you need to ask the following question. Of all these 20 criminals, how many were correctly classified?
That would be 15 divided by 20, 75%.
That means your model missed 25% of the criminals. Yikes. The third thing you need to assess is the specificity of your model. Your testing dataset has 80 innocent people in it, the halo emojis.
To assess the specific ability of your model to correctly classify innocents, you need to ask the following question. Of all these 80 innocents, how many were correctly classified? That would be 70 divided by 80, and that will give me 87.5%. That means your model popped 12.5% of innocent people in prison. Oops. Finally, if you care about a general metric reflecting the model's accuracy, you need to ask the following question. Of all the 100 tested people, how many were predicted correctly? That would be 70 plus 15 divided by 100, and that will give me 85%. Just remember, it's essential not to rely solely on this metric in isolation from others. That was really good, Sherlock. Thanks for your help, please. Hope you like how Sherlock explained the confusion matrix. If you like this content, please subscribe and smash that like button. See you in a week's time.